In this video, we are going to learn how to create a dynamic button, fancy button and beautiful buttons without wasting your tons of time. And are you still wasting your time by designing buttons into a sketch, like fancy beautiful buttons, and it taking lots of time every time you are managing buttons? Like sometimes whenever you create the button, sometimes it's a long text, sometimes a small text. Every time you are adjusting padding, margin, top, bottom, or whatever. Well, sometimes, and most of people, how they create the button: write text, create rectangle, do button formatting, border color and border radius and whatever. After creating all things, adjust alignment with proper padding or margin, top, bottom, left, right, whatever looks good. And if you duplicate and change text, like small or long text, then again the same process repeats again and again and again and again. So much time it takes. And one of my favorite plugin which I use most, the plugin is dynamic buttons. So you need to install the plugin into Sketch. Here is a URL you can see over here, and you can also download from the Sketch package manager. Now right now I'm going to download this plugin from here. Just simply click on the download button and download zip folder, and it will download into your local machine. After that, just double click on dynamic buttons sketch file. Message will come out and say the dynamic plugin installed. And now back to into your sketch, check your plugin. Just go to plugin and check dynamic buttons, create text like button, and press command J. You are thinking, what's happening over there? What is that? Don't worry about this. Just double click over here, and now you will see some value over there. So this is the top and bottom padding and the left and right padding. This is a parameter. So let's suppose I want to give the top padding 10 and bottom padding 10. So simply I change the value over here, and again press command J. Boom. So again, you can format also like the background color or whatever you want, and border radius, and also change the text. Boom. Again, I'm going to create another button. Just simply like change the text, small text like hello. And again, I just press command J. Boom. So it is very simple. It saves you lots of time. So just simply you create the button, and just every time you change the text, and just press command J, and everything, boom. Woo. So here is a pro tip for you. So if you will convert this thing into object, and it will blow your mind. The thing is over here. So the thing is, if I have my button and I just create the symbol of this button like this, this is now symbol, and again I just duplicate this button, and let's suppose if I change the name, new button, and again I press command J, boom, it is working, it is really working. So what will happen? Let's suppose you have a big project, then there is a 50-20 buttons all around your artboard. Simply you create the symbol and one click change everything. Example, you have a lots of button and you want to change the background color. It's simple, like I want to put the gradient over here. So it is very simple. So I hope you like this video. If you like this video, please give me a thumb. I'm expecting lots of thumb, and please don't forget to subscribe my channel. I will provide you lots of content about design. And please share your love, and please share this video. Thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you.